My name is Anand Sarwate. I'm an assistant professor in the Electrical and Computer Engineering Department at Rutgers, the State University of New Jersey. So my research is about how to get different entities or individuals, so it's perhaps two institutions, like two hospitals, how to get them to share data safely about their private populations of patients in order to learn about the collective population without violating the privacy of the individuals in their individual hospitals. My parents moved here from India. My father is also a professor of electrical and computer engineering at the University of Illinois. So I didn't really have that much pressure, though, growing up to be a scientist. I have an older brother. He majored in history and then went into law. And I just really enjoyed math and science growing up. And I enjoyed asking those kind of questions. And I had some experiences doing self-guided learning projects and so on, like individual projects and also group projects with other people in high school. And that really, when I got to college, made me want to pursue research opportunities there. So it's interesting. The field more specifically that I've been working in is in machine learning, which is a type sort of subfield of computer science or signal processing, depending on how you look at it. So when you hear the phrase machine learning, you might think, oh no, the machines are going to learn and then the robots are going to take over, like some kind of Terminator, Skynet sort of scenario. But no, machine learning, it's basically trying to use statistical models to understand the world and then trying to figure out how do you get a computer to learn from examples using these statistical models. So really one phrase, the older phrase for it might be learning from examples. And this is a bit different than what you might think of as artificial intelligence, which was trying to get computers to learn how to reason or trying to figure out how to make computers reason. More specifically to my research, a problem that I work on that is a machine learning problem is related to schizophrenia. I collaborate with people in New Mexico who use MRIs to study mental health disorders. And in particular, one thing that they look at is, can we, by merging data from several different private sites, can we learn across this data to see if we can find bigger patterns that are different in the brains of schizophrenics versus the brains of people without schizophrenia. So if everything magically worked out and all of my algorithms work perfectly and every piece of software just runs right away, we would hopefully see a really big improvement in our understanding of human health conditions of the type that you can learn from large populations. And finally, topic which is very important to me personally is really using these kind of data sharing techniques to get a better handle on understanding mental health disorders, which I think are very prevalent and also highly stigmatized in our society, and it's a real shame. And I think that things that we can do to increase our understanding of how these diseases function in the brain and ways to detect and mitigate their effects can really lead to a lot of improvements in human health. Well, every day is different, but fundamentally a lot of my work is very collaborative. So I try to spend a little bit of time doing my own work, but I also often spend a lot of time working with the students in the lab or with other students on campus and students of other faculty members. The research that I'm doing fits within a bigger picture of how computation and other kinds of data mining and machine learning algorithms, how those interface with societal issues like privacy and ethical issues like fairness. So I think that going forward, looking at more of these kind of issues where computation runs up against our values as society will be really interesting and a fruitful direction for research. And I think in particular that, what we want to avoid, of course, is a sort of big brother scenario that we see in these dystopian novels. And one way out of that is to start asking these questions now about how do we measure and model these notions of privacy and fairness and representation and diversity, both from a sociological standpoint, but from a computational standpoint as well. Yeah, I mean, I think the beautiful thing about doing research is that you more or less get to decide what you're working on, right? So if you have something that's really interesting to you, that you get really fascinated about, you can go and take some time and work it out and doing a PhD or doing or advanced work in research work and research training, what that really gives you is a set of skills that lets you figure out how to take a big complicated problem and break it down into smaller problems, and so that you then understand how to address those big picture questions. If there's something you're interested in right now, you should follow that right now. And then later on, you might find something else interesting. I know people who switched from computer science to biology, and now they have a actual biology lab with pipettes and everything, right? And vice versa. I know people who've gone the opposite direction. So I think that this is one of the beauties of being able to go into a research-focused direction.